Now, YBN Nahmir, what happened to this man's career, bruh? At one point in time, Nahmir's career was looking brighter than, I don't know, my forehead? That shit's kinda bright. In this video, I wanted to look back at Nahmir's career, look at his come up, what exactly did he have going for himself at the time of his blow up, what exactly went wrong, and what can he maybe do to make a comeback? With that being said, yeah. Let's talk about it. Now, YBN Nahmir, a young rapper who a lot of people probably at least recognize. Nahmir has been present in the game for a little bit of time now. He of course blew up back in 2017 with Rubbing Off the Paint, produced by Beats by Isaac, which was a really hot record back then. Bounce Out With That, directed by the one and only Cole Bennett, was huge as well. Namir's climb in the industry was pretty interesting. The fact that he was coming up alongside the guys, YBN, as he himself was taken off, allowed him to create a very powerful way for himself. All that hype was not only feeding into his name, but the YBN collective as a whole. Just reminiscing on when Nahmir was blowing up back then, man, was he in a good position. Just looking at his career now, all these years later, and it's literally night and day. I could have sworn Nahmir was gonna have one hell of a time in the industry when I heard Rubbing Off the Paint for the first time. The thing about Nahmir is he was really on the up and up the second Rubbing Off the Paint dropped. The record came out September 2017, it comfortably carried him all the way into early 2018. That's when Bounce Out With That dropped, so he at that point had officially acquired the cheat code to the rap game, which we all know what that is. I don't even have to say it, but I'm gonna say it, a Cole Bennett video. Enough said. The biggest issue with Nahmir is the fact that he simply didn't strike while the iron was hot. Word on the street is that Nahmir left the iron in the freezer, and I stole that joke from one of my subscribers. Visionland, Nahmir's debut project that came out earlier this year, is a good example of what I'm talking about. Even though the project ended up dropping on March 26, 2021, it was actually announced back in the 30th of August, 2020. It was scheduled to drop that same year on Nahmir's birthday on December 18th, which is my birthday, so clearly Nahmir copied my whole flow. I'm not dropping my album on my birthday. 2021, now feel better about it, he said on Twitter, and continued saying, just want to enjoy the rest of the year. I'm sorry. Love you guys. Now, reading this tweet, I always assumed that him not dropping back then had everything to do with him not wanting to drop, because like Nahmir himself said, 2021, that's when I'll feel better about dropping. Nahmir went on an album promo run a few weeks before the release of the album, and he did an interview with Hip Hop DX where he revealed some things.
I don't know, you just gotta deal with a lot of stuff when you sign an agreement. You feel me? When you sign something, you gotta, you feel me? You gotta deal with it. It's time for everything, and some people think it's not gonna be a hit. Some people think music is not right yet. It's a bunch of stuff when you do that type of shit.
Nahmir was speaking about some of the pressures he was up against internally, which was coming from his label. Like a lot of people already know, Nahmir is signed to Atlantic Records, which is the house for some of the biggest stars in the industry. My guess is that he just wasn't his label's priority at the time. He wanted to drop on his birthday, but the label most likely had another plan for him. At the end of the day, Nahmir is under a major label, so there's naturally gonna be a lot of internal competition between all the artists that are under the label. Considering the fact that Nahmir isn't all that hot anymore, and there we have a situation where you want to do one thing with the resources that have been allocated to you by the label, but you're not only not putting up the numbers or the records, this other rapper we signed a couple months ago is getting a lot of traction, so you know what? You're gonna have to wait. In Nahmir's case, as he was rapidly moving up the industry and as his name was growing, there just wasn't a lot of activity from him on the music end. Yes, the YBN mixtape dropped a year into his time in the industry, but clearly that project didn't have enough of an impact to keep Nahmir on the up and up. I think Nahmir simply failed to capitalize on the moment when it mattered the most. He had a pretty strong wave going for himself when he was blowing up back then, but the impact of his blow up wasn't so strong to the point where that alone carried him. To me, Nahmir always came across as that young rapper who was just missing that fire in his belly. Did Nahmir get lazy too quickly? Or was it just a situation where he didn't have all the right circumstances playing towards his advantage? Could be both, one or none. My perspective of Nahmir is he was lacking that urgency to get ahead in the game. We could always draw the comparison between him and Cordae. Now, is Cordae more talented than Nahmir? I would say so. Is that the reason alone why Cordae is at the forefront of the rap game while Nahmir is not? Absolutely not. Cordae simply took his career by the horns, so to speak. He was determined to get ahead, which is why he now is ahead. He kept a pushing, put up the records, and the rest is history. I think Nahmir could have been in a great position at this point in time had everything played out like it was supposed to. Nahmir is one of those young rappers who I think never got the chance to, you know, while he was extremely hot, display what he was really capable of. He had a couple hot records and was popular in the game for a period of time, but that wave eventually subsided, and now here we are today in 2021, where Soul Train is a thing. For Nahmir to make a comeback, number one, man, he needs to go back to his roots. What exactly does that entail? Well, for starters, I don't think it would be such a bad idea to go back to working with Beats by Isaac, which is the producer who made the Rubbing Off the Paint instrumental. I also think Nahmir stylistically has lost a little touch he had. I'm making this comment based off of the music on Visionland. Soul Train aside, if I gave you what, Nahmir's music just doesn't hit the same anymore. Nahmir, I believe, has lost a lot of that energy he used to have when he first came in a game. Happens to a lot of young rappers, but in Nahmir's case, he never got the chance to fully reap the rewards of his blow up. That's why I think his case is a little bit different. Now, he did successfully blow up, and that in itself is a blessing, but the high he once used to be on compared to where he's at right now, like I said earlier, it's night and day. He just never really got the chance to make an impact on people. That's one of the things I personally think has worked against him. On top of that, Nahmir quickly became one of those non-essential rappers in a culture who people didn't really care to keep up with. And on top of that, he didn't capitalize on all that momentum he had back then by dropping a solo project. Had Nahmir dropped Visionland at the peak of his popularity, even if the project wasn't good, which personally I didn't think it was that good, despite any of the negative reception he would have ended up receiving on it, he would have definitely at least had one more shot to redeem himself on that second drop. Simply because one bad project isn't gonna turn everyone against you, multiple ones will, however. In this Nahmir case, the issue with Nahmir dropping his solo debut so late is the fact that most people this time around didn't care too much about it because it was way overdue. Throughout these past few years, Nahmir's fanbase has also been thinning out. So the fan base that was supposed to show up for him on this release didn't show up. Now some of them did, but they quickly left again when they realized that the album wasn't worth the wait. Despite all this, Nahmir might actually have it in him to make a comeback. His album did actually have a couple okay records. One of them was really good actually, I'm talking about Opstoppa with 21 Savage. The direction he took with this release, however, that's where it went wrong. And to be quite honest, I think Nahmir could do way better than Visionland. I hope Nahmir makes a comeback, man, because why not? Personally, I think his career is far from over. Is it gonna be hard for him to get back on a horse, so to speak? Yeah, that is not an easy task, but it can be done, and I hope he succeeds. But yeah, YBN Nahmir, what exactly happened to his career? Well, if you watched the video, then you know. Any thoughts on this entire conversation surrounding the boy Nahmir? Are you guys checking for him these days? Definitely, let me know in the comment section below, and let's have a discussion about this.